course, very keen that the cow is given a special status, the holy cow. And it's not even, there's a very practical reason behind it. The Hindus claim that the one animal that made human beings become civilized and settled down is this holy animal, that this animal that we call the gentle cow. Before we came across the cow, humanity was just, if you like, hunter-gatherers, running around, killing, hunting, so they were not able to settle down. Only when we discovered this lovely animal called the cow, we realized that we had ready-made supply of protein. Just give dry grass at one end, you get protein at the other end. So we discovered a magic animal, the cow. And because of that reason, for thousands of years, the Hindus have given special reverence to the cow. They revere all life form, but the cow has got a special status. This is the basics of why the cow is considered to be holy. Now, the issue arises, what about eating meat? What about eating beef? Now, you see, those Hindus who are brought up in the very traditional families will be told, no beef. You can eat meat, perhaps, but no beef. By the way, they did survey in India about a few years back. 60 or 70% of Hindus in India eat meat, fish, eggs, or seafood. 60 to 70%. It doesn't mean Hindus can't eat meat. That's number one. You must take it off. You can't say you are defined by your vegetarian menu. Now, what about the idea or issue of beef? Really, I'm very as rational a Hindu as you can perhaps come across. And I'm saying, think for yourself. If you feel you revere this animal so much that this animal that has allowed us to become civilized, settled down, and we don't rather not eat this meat, we may eat other meat but not this one, then it is your choice. But the good part about Hindu tradition is it never gives you prescriptive religion, saying it's fixed, you can't do this, you can't eat this, you can't eat you. It doesn't give you any fixed prescription, thankfully. It lets you think for yourself. So if your family feels comfortable, you feel comfortable, that's your choice. I'm not encouraging it, but I cannot say that because you did this, you are no longer a Hindu, you are outcast. I can't say stuff like that. You can be Hindu and you can eat human meat as far as I'm concerned. I'm not encouraging it either, by the way. But this, you must be open in the way you react to such questions.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism. Sponsored by People Care. Encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.